This
Maybe so.
conference will now be recorded.
Cool. So, yeah, so the first thing is hackathon tips. I have my little thing here pulled up. Okay. So yeah, like hackathon tips. Definitely recommend looking at GitHub. So I'm going to actually I'll do this there because maybe more people will join later. So let's start with the actual project. So as some of you may have heard or like looked at the chat, Andrew said we will be making a to-do list app because that's what we're doing. So that's what we're going to be starting out with. So can everyone head over to REPL.it? I will send a link in the chat, but it's yeah, the link is REPL.it, and it's like a programming software, so online. So everyone head over there really quickly if you can. Tell me when you guys are all there. Like, write yes or there or something in the chat so I know. Hey, John, just saw you arrive. So just REPL.it. Everyone get to REPL. And then open and create. Okay, so if you're there, create a new REPL. Yeah, I'll just do it. So create new. So it should look something like that. So just create a REPL and click the HTML, CSS, JS, and then you should get a screen that looks like this. Say yes if you're at this looking screen. I'll move from there. Cool. Okay. So I'm just gonna assume everyone's there, by the way. So yeah. So yeah, let's get started. So you see there's three files called index.html, script.js, and style.css. So we'll be working with all of them, but let's start out with the top. So at the top, click the little pencil near your name and then type in, like to-do list. Or like something that like indicates that it's to-do list. So now your project is called to-do list. If anyone, oh, by the way, like if anyone thinks I'm going too fast or like wants me to slow down and explain something more, or has any questions, don't like hesitate to ask in the chat. So the next thing you want to do, oh, or yeah, unmute. Unmuting works too.
Could you When you were making the new REPL, which one did you choose? Sorry, I didn't see.
Yeah, no, that's fine. So HTML, it should say HTML, CSS, and JavaScript.
Okay, thank you.
Tell me if you still need help. Okay, so cool. Now we have that. So let's start out with, so the first thing you want to do is go over here in the script.js thing and then click the three dots and then click rename, calling it app. That just makes it easier. I don't know. That's just like a naming convention that I like, but you guys could keep it as script if you want. But I'll be using app, so it's probably, yeah, no, change it to app because I'll be coding using app. So yeah. Okay. So let's look at like the basic markup. So you're given this class, right? Essentially you're gonna have to do a few things. So you have this stuff, which is all good. Don't touch this, the viewport and stuff. That's like kind of a default thing. And so there's nothing really you need to screw there with. But one thing you may want to add is next to the content, like next to the width dot that, you want to write initial dash scale equals one. That just like scales your screen. So the next thing you want to do is in your title, if I'm going too quick, by the way, please tell me. So, because I don't know. So the next thing you want to do is write in your title to-do list. So Before we even get started, the first thing you want to do is like in a new tab, you see where I'm zooming in, there's like a box with an arrow. Click that and then you'll open a new tab. And that's where you'll see all your code run and stuff like that. So, is everyone caught up? That's yeah, please just tell me if I'm going too quick. But yeah, essentially you want to do that, and then so now you have your open tab, but in the top bar you can see it says to do dash list. So if I were to make it like if I were to make it Helix, then you would see this top bar, refresh the page, it's a Helix. So the title is essentially what happens in the top bar of your window. Okay. So we're gonna make that back to do dash list, and then we start working with it. So the first thing we want to do is this is already a default to check our style.css, and our style.css is essentially this place where we'll start styling and making our thing look all pretty and stuff. So next, so that's like enough for the heading, and we're done there. And then so in the body tag, like here where it says body, you want to, so like a basic HTML thing is that like at the end of every, like thing you want, so this is head and then you see slash head. So these are just end markers in which like you can like indicate where everything's happening in like certain sections. So like you'll see it more in depth later. But yeah. Are there any questions? Any questions? Okay. Cool. Okay. So now we have our script.js. That thing allows us to do that. So if you renamed your thing to app.js, please, please, please make sure that you do app.js right here where it says app. So yeah. That's just better and like it. Honestly, just tell sorry. So, you'd probably want to move this outside of the body tag. So, under where it says slash body, you want to move the script dot source thing, the original default code there. And then in the body tag, you want to create an input. So, what an input does is really obvious. It's like, it literally just takes in an input from the user. So equals quote input. So you don't have to worry about the ID thing. Oh, is there a question? Okay. Why are we moving script tab outside of the body? I will get more to that later because you'll see that like come into play with the JavaScript and stuff like that. But yeah. So just move it outside of the body for now. I mean, you could honestly keep it in the body if you wanted. I can do that too. It's just like a notation kind of thing. So for placeholder, you want to say what needs to be done. Because like, so the placeholder will essentially act as like asking a question, right? So like, how was your day? Or like that, and then it's like they input the answer, right? So pretty self-explanatory. The next thing you want is an UL or unordered list, which displays your like tasks. So for now, like don't worry about where I say ID equals quote list or anything. You have to write that though. Like make sure you write these things, but like I'll explain them when we get further into the tutorial. Any other questions before I move on? Are there any questions? Is everyone caught up? Because I don't want people, to not caught up. Yeah, just everyone, please say yes or something in the chat so I know that you guys are caught up. Cool. Oh, hey, Shrey. So cool. I'm gonna move on to. So In a to-do list, the three main things you do were like what you'd add tasks, and you would remove tasks when you're done from them, right? When you click on them, like they remove because you're done with them. You can create new ones and like so yeah. So that's like the way you implement them is functions that runs whenever a certain key is pressed, because that's like just the easiest way to like detect user input. And so then like essentially what will happen is when you click enter, there'll be text like that gets added into the list that we made up here. And that will like at that moment the input text box will also be erased when you click it, like because when you click a list, like when you click the to-do list, it'll like go away because like you're done with the task. So the way we do this is go into our app.js file. So everyone get to there and then we'll keep going. Tell me when you guys are all there. Okay. Or tell me if you need time. So I'm gonna just start. So the first thing we need to do is write a function that adds task or new items. Okay. So we could call it function new item because it's a new item to the to-do list. And then we need to add the following variables. First is the variable for the item that we're creating. So this is the task that we're gonna have, right? So the way we do the item creation is a super common class called getElementById. So getElementById and then quote input dot value. Okay, so is everyone like so the way this works is here, right? We said ID equals input, so we just define that the whatever happens in this input box is like an input, right? So I actually should show you how this works. So oh God. And don't worry about how it's like super to the edge. The reason being is because one, I zoomed out, but two is that we haven't styled it, so it looks really ugly right now. But if I was to type like hello, then yeah. So you can now type stuff in that box if you were to run your code, which is kind of cool. So the first thing is the item. So people would start inputting their items into the box, and then what would happen is this variable would get the items using the dot value thing because it knows that input is this box. Does that make sense? Any questions on okay. Just ask me if you have any questions on anything I'm saying. So the next is the var ul. That is the same thing. So document dot get element by ID. Quote UL, I think. Yeah. And then, oh wait, no, it's not UL. It's list. So, dot value. Okay. So the reason we use list is because, again, as you can see in the ID, the ID of the UL or the unordered list that will be displaying our tasks is called list. So what it wants is the value of the current list that's being displayed. If that makes sense. The next is the var list item. So I'm just gonna type it out and explain it. Not event. Oops. So autofills. So that's really cool with REPL. But yeah. So the way lists. So this last variable. The way lists work are. Here, let me just give you an example. So if I were to do this, then li hello. So now if I go here, You see a list that says hello. If I did the same thing that's like this, but goodbye. So then if I did this, then you get goodbye, right? So like you get a list like using that. So that's the way lists work, because so the li is what the objects in the list are. And so we obviously had to add them using user input, right? So that's why they're in the JavaScript instead of in the HTML file, if that makes sense. Yeah, please ask if you have any questions. So you essentially create this element, which is the li element, which means that you can start adding stuff in using the list component. So then what we do is we say li.append child document.create text node. Try that. Yeah. Quote dash and then plus item. So this is actually like, it looks like a bunch of random words, but like it's actually relatively simple. So the way this works is what happens is the variable set to the create element like method for the li tag should use the append child method, which is this one, and that's like how variable, like in any language, like most functions are called by dot, you know, the function name, which is append child. In this case, append child is a property of the li class, which is just like a different, you know, universe of code. But to create, and then that creates a text node. A text node is essentially, function is like a method in Java. Correct. A function is like a method in Java. Exactly. Like they're literally this, like it's not that much different. So then to create a text node, and then the reason you put the dash plus item. So we know that item is the input of the to-do list, right? So whatever they're like, today's task would be like this is cool or something, right? Like what would happen is it would take whatever goes into this box and then it display it as a list, which we'll later manipulate. But this dash here, it's not anything super complex, it's like a bullet point list. So like I can't show you that. So but yeah, it's just like a simple, you know, like if I were to go into Google Docs and be like, you know, just random like bullet points. So yeah. And then they'll just display the task list like that, just for a sense of, you know, how it works. So after you do the append child thing, what you want to do is add the list item that you created up here with the dash and the item to the UL, so, or to the unordered list. So add list. So a text node is nothing but like, it's essentially just text, but like combined, if that makes sense. Does that make sense? Like it's just text, like forget the entire node part. It's just like, it adds this element that like will later be, yeah. So no, it's relatively simple. Like it's literally just like a dash and then the item. So like it's a string. Yeah, it's essentially a string, but like, yeah, you'll manipulate it later, so it's like kind of more than a string. That's why they call it text node. But yeah, okay, so is everyone good? Does that answer your question? Sorry, my phone keeps going off. No, this is JavaScript for Jerry, and this is like HTML, CSS, JavaScript. Yeah. So yeah, exactly. String with more functionality. Good way to put it. So, okay. Do you want me to move on or like go over it again? Is everyone good? Does everyone understand everything that I'm doing so far? Yes? Cool. So document dot get, I'll just write it out and then I'll explain it because it's easier that way for me. Y'all, you guys can type this out with me, but yeah. So what does this do? Essentially, what this does is the document.get element by ID. So by ID is like super important. It's like essentially, thanks. But essentially the ID is like, you know, as I said, this like, you know, the ID over here. And like the ID is like all over this JS file, all over this HTML file. So yeah, so then you set the input ID, like the value, to empty, because if you like, so yeah, so the IDs are these things, right? Yeah, like essentially they're variables, but like not really. Like HTML has its own like thing, because okay, the thing is like HTML is a markup language, so it's really hard to like compare it to so right now you're basically programming in three different languages, but like so there's like, so the ID is essentially like this thing that identifies like what this block is and like what it does, so like you can use it in other classes. So what this line does is it sets the input to blank, because you don't want it to be like, like let's just say one of my inputs was hello. Here, let me refresh the page. Oh yeah, if you make a change, I would refresh your page. But if it was like hello, right, and then I clicked enter, and then like it showed me my list. It won't right now because like we didn't do the display thing. But yeah, I am recording this, so I am, right, bro. Okay, so it says, so like if I was like hello, then I clicked enter and it happened, right? Then like hello is still saved in the input variable, and if I was like guy, then like it was like it would also save in the input variable. So you want to make sure okay, so yeah, you want to make sure that like your input value is always you always want to make sure it's blank, so that people aren't like, so that like they don't keep random entering stuff. Is everyone like cool with that, or do you want me to repeat that? Because I know Jerry was like talking about the recording thing. Do you guys want me to repeat that?
Could you explain the so why do you have li.appendChild and then you have ul.appendChild?
Good question. So the li.appendChild essentially adds, so appendChild just means like adding something to something. So like what's happening is like it's adding like our item essentially in a formatted way to the list, and then that list item is getting added to the overall list, like the collection of list items, if that makes sense.
Oh, okay, I see.
Got it? Do you want me to re-explain that, or?
Oh, that's good, thank you.
Okay, cool. So, document, so does this make sense too? Like, where it's just blank? Yeah, okay. So now we want to make it so that if it's clicked, then it gets removed. Okay. So on click equals remove item. So right now, remove item, for those of you that know, is a method, but we just haven't created it yet. So we'll create that later. But essentially what we want is that if it's clicked, then it removes. It's like pretty obvious. So every time a list item is clicked, it gets removed, because that means you finished the task. So under the method here, under here, what we want to do is document, I'll just type it out and then I'll explain it. Wait, isn't it equal function? So yeah, just type this out and then tell me when you're done so that I can go over it. Tell me when you're done typing that out. Like in the chat. Oh, what the? Hold on. Let me bring back my screen. Done, done, done. Yeah, just everyone say done. I'll explain that later, sure. Everyone, yeah, done, done. Okay, I'm just gonna assume everyone's done. Is that good? Yeah, okay. So, walk through this. So, essentially on key up, so like yeah, so the on key up function is, or the, so this is called an event. What this is an event, and like if you ever did Java, it's like it's the Java swing thing where you're like action listener. There we go. Yeah, so yeah, so essentially this is like that, but so you have this like variable, right? This like a document equals on key up equals function e. So essentially what happens is like the e dot key code is a key code for the enter key, because when they click enter, you essentially want them to like on like if that variable or e of the enter key, or like the key that they pressed, is 13 or the enter key, then you want to run this function, if that makes sense. So in which you want to run essentially the main class. Does that make sense? Yeah, correct. Yeah, correct. Okay. Should I keep going? Any questions? Okay. So after that, we want, so we have this remove item thing, right? Like it's just there, right? You want to create a function for it now, because you know it's not going to remove item. Like this isn't pseudocode like itself. So you want to put in a parameter e. What function? The on key up function? No, so the on key up function is different because it's just continuously being called. So anytime there's an on key up action, it's called. That's why it's a function of the document body. Does that make sense? Okay, cool. So yeah, remove item. I'm just gonna type it in, and then I'll type. It is smart. The people who made these are very smart. Okay, so what does this do? So like now we can, this is like the function for removing it. So looking back, we see that the UL is the parent function, is the parent like element, or the like entire unordered list. So this like big list that we're talking about, in which like the small list items were added. And then while the LI or the list item is the small or child element. So that's like the way like object structures work? Is it the parent object, in this case our unordered list, and then the list object, which is the order, which is the like child object. So to remove the list item, all we'd really need to do is like remove the child from the parent element. And so it's really like that makes it super self-explanatory, right? Because like you go e dot parent element essentially. This is just like it's just like there because like there's just like more behind it, but essentially from the parent element you remove the child element, which is list in this case. I'll talk about saving later, but yeah, e dot target, and then yeah, cool. So now that we have this working, John, yeah. When we call remove item, do we need to call it like remove item? So we already called remove item. It was here. And so that's your answer to your question. No, you don't need to call it like that.
You don't need to put like a
No.
parameter.
No, you
Okay.
don't. Because E is this is your event parameter. So it's like a imaginary parameter, I guess. You wanna talk about it like that?
Okay.
So yeah, so oh wait, we still haven't called JS, it's fine. Yeah, so we didn't run it Let me just make sure. Okay, cool. So that's fine. So go to your style.css. Does everyone have the style.css open? Or getting it open?
Wait, so for the previous function in JavaScript, so does the word target tell you like which element you have to remove? Okay.
Basically.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, we're just gonna go through the styling and then real should work. So no, E is the event triggered. So in this case it would be the enter key pressed. So that's why there's like E.get code. Like, cause if the up arrow is pressed, it shouldn't do anything, right? So like okay, is everyone on style.css? Just click yeah in the chat, please. Okay, that's most people. So style it. So the way you style stuff, so HTML. What? Yeah. So I mean, I'm fine with any speed. So, okay. So one really cute, one like really like cool thing about this is that like it gives you font families. Like that's just a cool feature about Replit that I like. So the font family that we're gonna be using is this Arial and like this font family, if you can see. So instead of Arial though, I'm gonna be using Avenir next because it looks cool. And then so now just like explaining how this HTML like how this connects. So everything is going to connect back to index.html. So I'm just gonna center. Okay. So give me 1 second. So okay, so everything's hung back to this HTML, and essentially the HTML tag, so like when we wrote HTML bracket that, it's talking about this entire, from here to here, style everything in there, and style it with this kind, right? So essentially, like, that's how CSS files are formatted. And then, give me 1 second. And then the next one is the, okay, the next one is, Okay, wait, we got HTML. We got, okay, and then the next one's body, I think. Yeah, so now you have to style the body, which is everything from here to here. Is going to be styled in this manner that we define under the body tag. So max dot width 500, I'm going to say, and then margin 0 auto. Correct. So, and then you want to style the input, which is this thing, this box over here. So then you want to go the and padding dash top. Which is 30 pixels. The width of the input box, essentially it's 500. And then the height would be 60. And that's like how the input box works. Font size is going to be the font size of the like thing inside. Yeah, inputs are referring to the ID. Yeah. And then border is 0. That's like just, that's like showing that there's no border. So refresh it, should look like this. So now it looks a lot better because it's like big, it's in the center, it's cool. This plugin crashed. What plugin? Yeah, get more time in. Okay, cool. Let me when you guys are good. Jalen, I don't know what's going on. Maybe try refreshing. Working? Everyone's good? Okay, cool. So, done. All right, cool. I'm just going to assume that's most people. The next thing is going to be input focus. It's easier to just show you what this does other than like, it's okay. Actually, it's pretty self-explanatory. Watch. If I click on this, you don't see any outline. But if I were to do that and then refresh it, if I clicked on it, you'd see this big ugly box. But like now without an outline, you will see a box, which is really cool. Good. because then you could just like it's a better UI design. So yeah. Okay, the next thing. Then after that you go li. I think text line left. On size. So 40 pixels. Let's do list. So yeah, I know. I only figured that out like 10 minutes before this, so yeah. Like a better way to do it 10 minutes before this. Okay. So now if we refresh it. So yeah, list style is essentially like if I was to go like bullet, pretty sure that's how it is. Wait, it's like so list styles is just essentially how it looks, like how the list looks. So like instead of since we already defined in our app.js that we wanted the list to have dashed lines, it doesn't matter for the list style. But like let's just say we wanted bullet lines, so like we'd have to make it bullet or something, you know? So hello. My enter key's just not working. Okay, cool. So it's almost done. And then li hover is text as decoration line dash. So this will essentially every time you tap on it, it'll like create a like straight like a strike through so that we know that we're removing it. Okay, so I'm gonna run this. Hopefully it works, because that'd be cool. It's not, hold on. Hold on. Okay. Is your guys's working? Is your guys's like doing stuff? Error. How are you getting error? John, what's your error? What's your guys's error? Can you paste it? Oh, you guys have to. Okay, so for John, your error, it has to be document.get element by ID, like this, like with the capital E. Yeah, try that. Maybe that'll help. Okay, Nithya, your error is also a type error. I think you just spelled. Mine is working fine. I'm not getting any errors. Okay. Wait, Shrey, are you getting that error too? Wait, Shrey, can you copy your error and paste it here again? Wait, how does everyone have a different error? Mine is working fine. Does anyone else? Is it just Nithya? Are you good? Do you have any errors?
I got like the append child error. I'm trying to look at it again and see if I get an error again.
Yeah, try like looking at typos and I think all of these are just typo errors. Because I think.
Well, we didn't code the feature to like add stuff to the list, so I think I tried doing that and I just didn't get anything after. Like we don't have an actual list like once I hit enter.
Yeah, I know. I'm fixing that one. I have an actual list. I don't know what's happening. Because my list is working. So where's yeah, so I'm gonna have Yeah, let me like fix these errors. So I think it's just typo errors for all of you guys. Can't read properly. Yeah, yours is literally, yeah. So if it says type error, you probably like did not screen to add drop JS. Sure. Try making sure that everything's typed well and stuff. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna have you do. Everyone, DM me your links. Not like DM, so like just send the links in chat, like to your REPL so I can see. I don't know why though. This is weird. Can you guys send your links? Okay, cool. And not scroll down at all. So yeah. Oh, Nithya, can you send your are your errors good? No, don't. Yeah, I'm figuring out the listing too because my thing, one of my things works. Like my old one works. Okay, I'm opening up all your REPLs now and just looking through them. So Nithya, thanks Jalen for helping out. Nithya, don't worry about the list yet. Do you have any errors? If you guys have errors, just send your links. Don't worry about the list yet, though, because I will go through that.
Oh, I have like an output, but only once I hit enter is there an error. Like when I type something in the box and then hit enter, it just shows an error after that. So I think something's wrong with the append child code.
Can you send me your REPL?
Oh, yeah, one second.
Like your actual code. Yeah, thanks. Okay.
I just went on your REPL and I got the same error that I got. So maybe
My
it's,
REPL should be
yeah.
fine. What? How? I'm not getting any errors.
Like if you put your thing in the box and you type and then you click enter.
Yeah, I'm clicking enter.
Oh, what the heck?
Yeah, I'm good. See, look, I'm spamming enter. You can hear
Bro, I literally just went on your, okay.
Wait, I didn't even send my REPL.
It's in
How'd you get on my
your
REPL?
bar at the top.
Oh yeah. But yeah, no, I'm fine. Spamming enter. Okay, so I'm gonna go to Shrey's. Okay, nice name, Shrey. I'm gonna figure out what's happening. Okay, so that's fine. Most of these things are like that. So, what the? Okay. Think you may have skipped a step. Okay, wait. This is so weird. I literally just ran your code, Trey, and you're fine. I'm not getting any errors for you. It's just not outputting the list. What is happening? Okay, so I'm going to figure this out because apparently I'm not getting any errors, but you guys are, which is really weird. Mine should work. Okay, here. Let me check a GitHub that had this whole. Wait. Here. Okay, can you guys still see my screen? Because I'm kind of switching over tabs, so I want to make sure you guys can still see my screen. So. Okay. Oh, you can't? What the? What? Hold on. Let me fix that. Give me a sec. Wait. Give me one second. I'm gonna fix my. Oh, I need to log into an account too, so. It's kind of good that it kind of broke because I don't want to leak my Okay. Hold on, give me one second. My thing is not being. Okay, I go into my GitHub. So here's my old project. So we can see what went wrong. I did this a while ago too. So me just click back here. Okay, so. Here's an old point. Okay, can just show you the demo that I wrote that I was writing. Let me open it up. Okay, I need to sign out of something. Give me a sec. Just kidding. Sign into something. I just need to. Okay, so here's how it should like. I think it's probably something with REPL, because my old one on like not REPL works. So maybe it is, but I'm gonna screen share. Yeah, see, why is your error gone now? That's so weird. Okay, here it is. So can you guys see my screen? So hello, Felix. Cool. Yeah, and then mine is working fine. I don't know. Jalen, what? Should we use REPL? Okay. If I'm being honest, REPL probably isn't the best, but it was the easiest to get everyone onto, because it's online and stuff. Because but yeah, mine was working fine. Wait, I just looked at my old code. Maybe it is this, because I didn't think this was a problem. But maybe it is. Hold on. Maybe we'll see. I will tell you if this good if this works because I think it's not adding it. Okay, maybe I didn't pay attention. We run it. Hello. And now I'm getting the error. Nice. If you want, yeah, you can use Glitch. Yeah, it's definitely an option. This has never happened to me before, so kind of. six. If it works on Glitch, can you tell me, Jalen? Because, like, I think it's definitely just some weird. Yeah, you can try it on Git. Yeah, you can try doing this, like, on another IDE, maybe. Because I think it's definitely, like, I ran my working sample just now, right? Did you guys see that? That's my working sample. So, I don't know. Like this works, and then if you click it, you should delete it like that. Okay. So yeah, it's definitely like something really weird because like right, mine is working. I don't know. Let me check. Yeah, let me try redownloading my thing. This is the working code. Here, okay, I'm gonna try putting it in, and if my thing works, then we'll see. This should, I'm just gonna re-put in all the code that runs this one in my GitHub. Okay. I'm gonna try putting this in and then we'll see if it works. Okay, so I'm gonna try running mine now and seeing if it works because I just copied every class. Okay, mine works. Can you guys check out my code? I'll send you a link because, yeah, mine works. So I'm gonna send you guys a link and we'll walk through it and see what happened because sometimes problems like this happen. Like, this happens to me all the time. So I do this stuff like a lot. Okay. Here's the app.js. This is definitely probably where we went wrong. This is probably not actually where we went wrong. I think I'm like looking back at the code and stuff, and then I think where we went wrong was here. So what happened actually is who asked us at the beginning? Nithya, right? Yeah. So at the beginning, there's two things that we had to do. Two things that REPL, by the way, kind of screwed up, but it's whatever. So you see here we have to put the outside of the body tag, like put the script outside of the body tag. So try that. That's one thing. Like just looking at the differences in our code. No. I just sent my REPL link. Wait, can you guys run it and make sure I'm like my computer isn't being like stupid? Because like does my thing actually work? Because like I know. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I think that's probably not it though. So I said that's like probably not it. But the other thing is probably the enter key. It works, right? Okay, cool. Cool. So yeah. And then there's also like I think my old code was just a lot better. I think the main problem was probably here. Works for me, right? Yeah. So I think looking at like this sometimes happens to me too. So like it's not anything like oh you're bad or like anything like that. I think oh draw needed. Okay. Yeah, John, what was it? Do you want to unmute and say it? Got it?
Okay,
Cool. This
so
is good.
basically, in the HTML file, you gotta put the script src outside of the body, because I
Yeah,
think.
so apparently, so that's what I said too. So Nithya did that, and apparently it wasn't working for
Oh, it worked for me after I did that.
her. Yeah, so I said that at the beginning. I was like, yeah, you should. But yeah, no, definitely, maybe, yeah. But does it work for you? Or are you getting lists? Is
Yeah.
everyone getting the list? Shrey. Oh, nice. So mine was off. Sarah, is yours working now? Okay, nice. Yeah, so let's walk through the class and then we can see where we went wrong. So I have the old thing, the old file pulled up, so we can see where we went wrong. Here, so here, let me open it back up. And then if you want, if some people want to stay, I'm pretty sure we can do another one. So, okay. So where did we go wrong? The strike through doesn't work? My strike through works, right? Yeah, I think there may be a discrepancy between the default and my code, because my code is yeah, I don't know. My code's probably, I mean, it works. There's nothing else we really need to get through. Just wanted to do this like cool project, but I don't know. If you guys want to. But so yeah, let's like I'm pretty sure it was the style, like the style sheet discrepancy. That was probably one. Script discrepancy was probably one. My formatting just generally is different than John. Does your wait? I'm pretty sure REPL comes with doctype.html. Yeah, I'll give kid tips after. So wait, I'm pretty sure the original did come with doctype.html though. Doctype HTML though. Oh. Okay, so other than that, one thing was so one thing we changed that actually did work was, do you see how these are single quotes now? Okay, the reason being is that the IDs are single quotes, but these aren't. Like that's just how it should be. So that is also something. Like the reason these are single quotes is because input is, remember I said input's this input, right? So like, and then this is list, so that's list ID, the ID list, which is this one. So that's why it's double quote. And I think that's like probably the discrepancy between codes and stuff. So yeah, just remember that. Definitely something cool. How to store the data, someone puts in a list. Yeah, so I feel like we can. So we store it. Maybe wait. I mean, storing it would be like another, like I need to teach about like servers and data, like different databases in JavaScript and like how to manipulate them and like that's just weird. But yeah, I would definitely like, if you do want me to talk about that like some other time, probably not now, because like that just confuse everyone. Yeah, I can definitely do that. Okay, so indent does not matter, no. I think most people's are working now, so if you still have a discrepancy, please take a look at my code and just like try to figure it out, because that's just how you get good at error analysis and stuff. Yeah, cool. Come to my 6 p.m. workshop on convolutional neural networks because it's fun. That's the cool stuff. That's what I'm good at. So mine doesn't show errors, but it doesn't work. Yeah, sure. Like then again, right? Like I'm pretty sure most people's work. Let's like you can just send me yours and or yeah. But I think that's all the time. Oh, eight. My bad. My bad. My bad. Yeah. Sorry, Ben. Yeah, my eight is yeah. Okay. I would look at my code, Nithya. I will send it again, and just like figure it out. Cause like this is definitely like a big part. Like error analysis is definitely big. So I'll look at your code though, and then just like maybe tweak something and send it back. Does JavaScript have? Yeah, definitely. So yeah, definitely. JavaScript's more of a web-based thing though, so there's differences, there's benefits, there's advantages, but yeah. Okay, anything else? Okay. If there's nothing else, I'm going to end the meeting. Share the link to my repo, my REPL. Sorry, my REPL. Yeah. Okay. So here. Hackathon tips. Yes. So, I'm going to do the same thing. Thank you for reminding me, Jalen. So wait, my mouse is broken. Hold on. Okay. Yeah, so first let me just send this link and then I'll get to the hackathon tips. Okay. Yeah, so I'm gonna just do a quick like, so the way that every single hackathon like winner, or at least in my experience, does it is GitHub. So if you wanna download it with me. I already have it, but like I'm just gonna show you through it. So when you go to GitHub, if you search up GitHub Desktop, then you get this thing, which is called just GitHub Desktop. So you know, depending on what you have, whether you have Mac, whether you have Windows, you click download. It knows I have Windows, so I downloaded the Windows version. When you click download and set it up, you have your GitHub Desktop. So hopefully you already have a GitHub account because that's really useful. So the way that we use GitHub Desktop in code is I'm gonna screw the sample like one repo that I have or like something that I've worked with just to show you guys. But can you guys see my screen for the GitHub Desktop? Okay, no, you can't. Hold on. Yelling at me. Hold on. So let me open. Okay, is everyone still here? Okay, so yeah, here's my GitHub Desktop. So, let me go to some random site. Okay, so essentially, if I go to this is called my this is like my first robotics team website. Actually, let's screw with the Hack the Helix site. So this is Hack the Helix site, the first one, the first draft. The other drafts are on Glitch. So if you show an explorer, then hold on, let me fix my screen. Keep screaming at me. Okay, screen. There you go. Okay, cool. So I'm sharing my full screen. So if I so how I got to here. So like when you create something. So I'm just gonna remove this and then click on remove. Oh no, the computer. Okay. Removed. So once we remove that, then you go file, then you can click file, clone repository, after you create it online, you can clone it. So if I was like, okay, I just created this, random like Hack the Helix website, so I want to clone. Okay, sorry, I'm getting all these random like notifications. So clone. So let's just say I created this random code for the coast. Yeah, that's good. Okay, bioinformatics, so whatever. So now you have this. So now you cloned it to a certain location. And then you click wait for it to download. There's just like a lot of files in this one. So yeah, so it just downloaded. So you go like, okay, here's the current repository. You right click here, you click show in Explorer. And then it's pulling up. Okay. So now that you have this window open, you can like manipulate stuff. So like if I were to go on source pages, this is like a super weird website, but now I can essentially edit stuff. So if I were to go, okay, I want to edit this thing, like this file, open with Atom. This is like if you want to use like a downloaded ID. Jalen, for the last workshop, like basically most of the stuff that I went through here was the same here, but there's like APIs and stuff that like you could just look up by yourself or you could watch the video. But yeah, so essentially I have like this code, right? And so if I, let's do a better example, because this is like you actually have to understand. So let's say here, this is a really good example. So on this one, you can right click, open Show in Explorer. Like this is on GitHub Desktop, right? And then if I was like, okay, I want to, this is for my robotics team, so I was like, okay, if I want to org, don't worry about how many files we have, but yeah. If I was like, okay, I want to edit this, so I'm going to edit this with Android Studio, so. But yeah, so I'd essentially open this and like, okay, fine, we'll open it in Atom. That's fine. Whatever. So now it's opening in Atom and we'll look at the file. Okay, so nice to see my Atom screen pop up. Sorry, let it open because okay, so let's say I edited this code to say, like set power method or something to 1, right? So now if I saved it, you go back to GitHub Desktop, and then, so now like, you can see here, right? So I changed it to 1. So then you click, so then I'm like, initial or something, right? Like some summary, then you click commit to master, and then you'll wait for it, and then you click push origin. So now anyone that like does the same thing, and then if someone else was to do that, then you get this thing called pull origin, and then you pull it, and then now you guys can both work on it. So it's just like a really cool way to like work on stuff, especially if you're doing the more advanced projects, and you'll definitely start using this in like industry. But yeah, are there any other questions? Anything else I should go over? Okay. And then, yeah, how many of you guys actually have like projects and teams set up? Just like curious, because they're spamming me at Discord. All right, cool. Nice, Cynthia. Is yours working, Shrey? Yeah, cool.